changing the vendors. The Clinical Establishment Act has been passed in the Legislative Council and accepted by Tamil Nadu government in June of 2018. This has come out as an act. Any clinical establishment, whether it is allopathic, ayurvedic, yoga, Yunani, anything, it has to be registered with Government of India, Health Department, so that they will come and check what we have, what we don't have, what we have been doing, and if it is not according to norms, those people who have been misusing the system will be termed as quacks. This is the basic idea. This has not been formed to harass us in any way. They just want to have a list of number of medical establishments, that is number of consulting rooms, number of hospitals, number of clinics, etc. In the detailed act, they have given the definition of each and every one of what they call as consulting rooms. Just for example, if they say that it is a consulting room, it means that the doctor or the homeopathic practitioner is just sitting there, listening to the patient, examining the patient, giving advice, giving a prescription. That's all it is. I think 90% of our members come under that. The next step is a clinic. A clinic means the doctor will receive the patient, maybe give an injection, maybe put a bandage, maybe do some suture removal, or in a small setup. That means for a consulting room, for example, if you have a table and chair, the minimum consulting room size should be 10 feet by 10 feet. That is 100 square feet. It need not be a square. It can be in other dimensions also. So you are expected to have a patient's reception area where patients can sit. You are expected to have a record room where you are supposed to maintain records for 3 years. Normally, this 3 years is not a hard and fast rule. For every patient, it is 3 years. For medical legal cases, it is till the case gets over. For a child, it is till the child attains adulthood, that is 18 years of age. If it is a postoperative patient, maybe you want to keep it for longer. It is an individual doctor's idea. But records must be maintained. There is a prescribed format in which the prescription should be given. The prescription format is given on the website of Tamil Nadu Medical Council website. Several of us have downloaded this and modified it to suit our needs. Apart from this, the next type of health establishment is the clinic. As I told you, clinic may or may not have a bed. If you have a bed, you are supposed to have a paramedical staff all the time on duty. It also is not mentioned, but it is going to be like this. If you have a bed and a paramedical staff, you will be expected to receive emergency cases and administer to them. Here again, let us say if you are a dermatologist, you will not be expected to resuscitate a cardiac emergency. If you are a gynecologist, you will not be looking at a general surgical emergency. But these are things which are not written down, but which can be made aware in the application itself, there is a format for it. The third type of thing is a polyclinic. Polyclinic means that there are more than one specialist doctor or more than one doctor in the same specialty, consulting at the same time. So if it is a consulting room, there are four consultants coming in at the same time and consulting. It goes into the category of polyclinic. It is no longer a consulting room. The next category is a hospital. Now, if you have additionally laboratory facility attached with your consulting room, you need to mention this in the application form. If you have X-rays, then there are some basic requirements which you must satisfy. Apart from the consulting room division, any other division must procure a certificate for biomedical waste management. The team which comes to inspect your health establishment after you apply, fill the form and pay the online fees of 5,000, which is mandatory for every health establishment, irrespective of what type of establishment you are showing. The team will ask you, sir, injection kudupinga, bandage maatringa, in the bandage enga dispose panna poringa. How are you going to maintain the sterility? So if you are a small health establishment, you do bandages. The suggestion is that you go to the nearest nursing home, have a MOU with them, sign a letter saying that your biomedical waste will be given to them and they will dispose it off accordingly. If you have a larger place, like a small hospital, 2-3 beds, then they are asking for stability certificate, building stability certificate. If the building is your own, then you have to approach the PWD department of Government of Chennai, Corporation of Chennai. Write a letter to the chief engineer asking him to come and inspect your premises. You will have to keep the ground plan and the building plan, construction details ready. They will inspect the place and then they will give a building stability certificate. This is necessary only if your patients are staying for several hours in your place or staying overnight. Like if it is a daycare center, maybe you are putting some drips or conducting delivery or doing minor suturing, then it is necessary. This stability certificate and biomedical waste certification is not necessary for small places like consulting room. If you have a bigger place like a nursing home or a hospital, there is no separate division as nursing home or hospital. Everything comes under the hospital. Then you are supposed to have fire safety certification also. For getting fire safety certification, when you visit the station chief at the nearest fire center, the first question he is asking is, sir, please give me your building stability certificate. When you apply for building stability certificate, that fellow was asking, sir, is the pollution certificate in order? Where is your sewage going? So the whole thing is interlinked. This certification is mandatory and we have to get it completed by 31st of March for all existing establishments. If you are starting a new establishment in March or April, then you are given 6 months to comply with the norms. I have already gone through this process for my clinical establishment and I have received the registration also. I went through a lot of hassles initially because the team which came to my place did not understand what exactly was needed from them. It was in such an early stage. But we went through it together and individually every single person helped us. They did not demand anything. In fact, they came out of the way to guide us how to get things done and then what registered. If members have any specific doubts, please ask me. I think I will be able to satisfy everybody. I think all of us must come forward and get it registered and get the certificate in our hands so that we consult patients in a hassle-free manner. So the basic equipment, if you ask for a consulting room, they will ask, do you have a blood pressure record? Do you have a thermometer? Do you have a tongue depressor? In my clinic, in my consulting room, tongue depressor, there is no work. So I don't have tongue depressor. I don't need to depress the tongue. They accepted it. There is no issue about that.
You said about documentation, it should be manual or electronic, or is it anything specified?
No, nothing is specified. If it is electronic, they are happy about it. But if it is manual, they are not insisting for electronic.
Something for qualified nurses around the problem.
They only say qualified paramedical staff. They don't say nurses.
Nursing staff, they want a diploma or a PhD.
Nothing like that. Just say qualified paramedical attendant from the that is not mentioned in the Act. Maybe they will come out with more stringent rules and regulations. Sir, CEA registration is one registration for one building. Let us say that you are a consultant in Apollo Hospital. Apollo Hospital will take the CEA on your behalf. You don't have to individually do it. But if you consult, let us say, even from a room in your house, Then you will need to get a CEA registrar.
How long does it take to get a continuous certificate once you apply to the corporation?
It will take a few months. What they ask is, sir, you apply. Give us a copy of the letter in which you have applied. We will give you the registration forms. Subsequently, when they come and clarify, we will take it forward.
One correction. This is issued by certified engineers, civil engineers, who got license from the corporation. They are, the numbers are with the health department already, who have hospitals. I think you are registered with the health department. There itself you have given everything. The health set, the stability certificate is issued for 5 years by a chartered engineer deputed by the Corporation of Chennai. They can issue the certificate, not the corporation. So they charge individually, their own charge. Within 2 days they give, and that will be valid for 5 days. If you have a lift, if they, that does not was included in your plan, then for the lift also you need to get an individual letter from the same engineer, scientific engineer. So this is not issued by the corporation. So this is simply issued by an appointed, gazetted, appointed, chartered engineer, civil engineer, who can issue the certificate. Fire, you see, I will add for him. Listen, fire is very easily done by us. The thing is, there are instrument suppliers, fire extinguishers, who have suppliers who issue the fire extinguishers according to your need. If it is the ICU, they have you have wiring and all, they have separate one with gas. And other where, somewhere it is only ash comes, means some, what you call, it's only, depending upon your floor needs, your cabinet needs, they give extinguisher, fire extinguisher. Those things, if you order to them, they easily take to the FO, means fire offices, local offices, they charge 6,000 rupees to 8,000 rupees, according to your own place and your own things, and things are done. This is already done by every hospital. For example, I have it for 3 years already.
How much is the charge for the chartered engineer?
For clinic, and I will add to this one, latest in the morning I have went through some other official WhatsApp group. The minister has told even single room he can excuse for all those things. For hospitals, extinguishers cost each and everything you have to bargain. But for the DFO office, first time they ask 10,000. If you have all plan, planning permission of every floor is in order, they can take less. But renewal itself, it is 5,000 to 7,000 rupees. And renewal with the health department, for us, not for you, for our corporation, for us it is 7,000 rupees renewal itself.
I'm asking about the corporation chartered engineer.
3,000 rupees minimum.
He charges 3,000
rupees for 5 years certificate. He will issue 3 copies in original form. Only copy you have to give every year to the renewal. Means for us only 5 years you have to renew with the government.
So he gives building stability 3,000 rupees, 5,000 to 7,000
for fire extinguishers. Depending upon your need, you will add the instruments, add plus the cost plus your what you call your fire service fire safety certificate from a DFO district fire officer.
So approximately 10,000.
2.5 kilogram ABC fire extinguisher, that is basic model, which will melt out powder, is 1,850 rupees. I know this because I purchased it for my residence. Our building, residence building, does not have fire safety norms. I thought individual safety we should have. I purchased 2. Each one cost about 1,850. Maybe if you get 10, they will give you a discount.
Thank you.
Does it mean
that when you have the fire
Sir, what is the kind of clerical work that is needed? Filling up, form filling?
There is a mobile app, there is a website also. It would take you approximately 20 minutes to fill out the entire application form. 20 to 30 minutes.
That's, step by step it goes. As first step you fill and you are busy, you save it and then you save for life. And then you can open to the second step and then you save the second step and you are busy, you saved it and second page is also there. Then third and fourth step you have a payment for hospital.
My question is this, from the branch perspective, if members want any, I don't know whether all members can really do all these things. So from our branch side, we can have one part-time somebody recruited for this purpose, right, let us say for 6 months or 5 months from now, and they can help those who are unable to, you know, go through this whole procedure. So whoever is willing, please, by end of this meeting, please give up, you know, your names, right? Therefore, now we will recruit somebody, right, on your behalf, right? It, branch will bear the expenses, don't worry about it. Branch will bear the expenses, but we will try and help you in all this clerical filling up, right? And we have seniors here, Dr. Arunachalam, Dr. Subramanian, who have already done these things. There are a number of people who have done this. With their guidance, we will see that, you know, all of you have helped. Right? If there is any bribe and things like that are needed,
sir, no
then
bribes.
We will,
no
as a branch, you know, we will not be able to respond.
No, right? Sir. I will add to your point. It is a very welcome, nice point from the president. Just to help the members from office itself, that is a very nice one. And second thing is, don't panic. That deadline will be expanded as usual. And the government policy is not to harass us in the first year, just to enroll everyone who comes as it is. From third year, these things will start. Now not. First year, they will allow you to register freely. Second year, the inspections will start. From third year, it will be a bureaucracy, will be there, and we have to pay everything as usual. But first year, it is only gently they ask you to register. They want the data. And the data means March 31st, January, February 28th for all senior citizens, 70 people, all these things will be expanded, definitely. But you move on from now itself so that the dead end of March, maybe the symptom, the website may go crack or collapse.
Okay, I have a small request to the members present here. We will try to help, from the branch side, we will try to help all the members, right, by recruiting one or two, you know, let's say graduates or somebody we will recruit. Therefore, there is some assistance available to you. One thing is, we'll have to work out the kind of workload that is going to accumulate. So you will all of us have to cooperate, right? Please give the names, give your names. Therefore, you know, if somebody calls you, please cooperate and all that. Also spread the word to all our fellow members of Konumbakkam branch. Therefore, the entire list is available with us. Then we will know how many to recruit and how long it will take and all those things. But we are willing to provide this free of cost, right? All other expenses we will, you have to pay.
A couple of things here.
Yeah.
Just like Dr. Arunachalam said, you can save the application at any point in time, close the website, and then call up the skilled person from the branch to take his advice on what you should fill up.
Okay.
Only when you make the payment of 5,000 does the filled application get registered, after which you won't be able to edit your data. So to start filling up, first of all, you must have an email ID. So you go in, give the name of your consulting room, whatever you want to put it, put your email. Then they will mail a password to you, use that password and open the site and start filling. About 5 to 7 steps are there, depending on what type of establishment you choose. Before you make the payment, I would suggest you take a printout of each page or click a photograph in your cell phone, discuss with any of us, saying that if you've done it right, then you can go ahead and make the payment, then the people will come to inspect. This is one point. Second point is, for establishments that are not owned by any of you, they ask in a particular subdivision, who is the person in charge for this establishment? There are many people here who would be practicing in building which will have several consultants coming in at several times of day. There will be a lab running, there will be a pharmacy running. So the building manager or the building designated in charge, that person's number you must give. This is one aspect. Secondly, they are asking in a particular subdivision, what is the total area of the clinical establishment and what is the built-up area? If it is your own house of which a room you are consulting, then you must consult your floor plan. These two things you have ready, then most of the filling up of the form will be very easy. Save it before you make the payment, discuss amongst us, then you make the payment and wait for them.
it is not mandatory for you to have mercury manometer at all. Digital BPR, this is okay. Digital thermometer is okay. Just have these stationary ready. In my case, when they came, they asked us for stationary. In my consulting room, four of us doctors in the family practice at different times. Each of us have their own letterhead and their own prescription. We showed them. They wanted to know if all of us use the same stationery. Then they say it is a polyclinic. If you have individual stationery, there is no problem. So we had the things ready. They came, they approved, and they granted the license.
The second question is, how do you dispose the biomedical waste generated? For example, in syringes, you need to take an agreement with some person.
If you have a nursing home which is known to you, or if there is a nearby nursing home, just talk to them. Maybe if you are having, let us say, 20 patients a day, giving 10 injections, you will not be generating even 1 kilogram per day. So just hand over the pair back with the disposables to the nearby nursing home. Let them dispose it. Just take a letter from them saying, so and so doctor from this clinic or consulting room will be giving the biomedical drugs and we are disposing it off. That letter you have ready. If you have an establishment in a rented building, contact the owner of the building, ask him for the details. If you have a clinic or establishment in a rented building, then you need to say who is in charge for that building. And you need to say what is the total built-up area, etc. That will be available only with your owner. So get the details from him. Tell him that there is no harassment involved. Just asking some basic things. Because obviously, these people have seen many very small clinics running from very small locations. And they want to avoid that.
What answer that? Sukumar's query. The disposal can be done in the nearby nursing home, which we have, myself and Dr. Singh was practicing nearby or approached, where we have treated patients in Maya nursing home. So we have approached them and they have said, we will do that. And they are paying an amount. And we said, we will contribute something. It's a nominal fee for them to do our job. That can be done. That's easily possible. You can dispose it in whatever specifications they say. Once in 2 days or once in 3 days, you put it in the colored bin or so and so. It can be done. That's not a problem.
Next comes at CAB Credit Levels. On behalf of IMHNA, welcome. I thank Dr. Subramanian and Dr. Anachana for the wonderful work and Dr. Subramanian, you spent almost a month. So, from this, the 434th IMA meeting, we are getting CMA treaters of point, there is half-end point. So, I think for much more on the talk of this CMA treaters, I request Dr. Subramanian to proceed.
Very short summary is saying that I have not spent too much time. When the credit system started,
I have sacrificed my case to
when the credit system started, IMA Kodambakkam was getting half credit hour for every meeting. Then the medical council shifted from manual to digital. In between, we lost our crediting system. Then this itself was conveyed to us many months later. So over the past several months, with Dr. Arunachalam's guidance, persistence, criticism of my style of activity, etc., I was able to put in some good work. If he had not prodded me, I would not have done this, because I am basically a lazy fellow. So what we have now done is, we are able to get credit for the hours or the months we have lost initially.
Retrospectively.
So from the period 1-4-2012
good.
To 31-3-2017, whatever meetings you have attended, according to our attendance book, every meeting you will get half credit hour. this list has been compiled. This week it will go with the covering letter to TNMC, and whoever has whatever points will be credited. Number two, for the next period, 1-6-2018 to 31-12-23.
Sir, may I just add a point here? For the retrospective period, you can have a there is a record, right? We have all the members who have attended, and Dr. Subramaniam had. I think I'm audible. Dr. Subramaniam has compiled the whole thing, and whoever, according to the registration number, right, your medical council registration number, your credit hours, number of hours, the credit point is given already, right? Kindly go through this. We will circulate it in the mail, and not in the mail. I think it's better to.
I will say what is in your mind. Will put it forward.
Okay, you got the point, right?
Yeah, I got
okay,
the point.
I will help people.
So what he says is, we have compiled the list. Many of us are specialists. We go to some meeting. They give 10 hours in that meeting, so we are happy. But several of us here are individual practitioners who have either not collected the certificate or not registered properly, or we feel that maybe we will not get 30 hours in that 5-year period. If there is anyone in this audience who has such a doubt, kindly let myself and President know. We think we can help you out. Instead of going to TNMC and saying that, look, I don't have the hours, you shift it to the next period, I will pay the fine. Before you do that, first you come to us, we will see what we can do. Then if we can't help you out, then you go to TNMC. There are norms to do that also. For this also, you have only 1 month time.
Yeah, so 1 week's time, if they can give us a feedback, then
individually, every member, if you can give a feedback, you feel that you have not earned 30 hours, you please let
30
me...
30 points.
No, not points. Points is meant MGR Medical University for students.
Okay.
Credit hours.
30 hours. Okay.
Okay. 30 credit hours. What it transpires is, if you have 4 study hours, it is 1 credit hour. It is an approximate calculation. PNMC has their own variables on this. Approximately, if you have 4 study hours, you get 1 credit hour. If you have natural speakers, you get extra. If you have international speakers, you get extra. If you have not registered and changed your meeting invitation at the last moment, you'll get less. If you haven't submitted the attendance certificate, you get 0, etc., etc., etc. So this is the approximate calculation. So if you don't have any other meetings to ask for credit hours, and if you have come to IMA Kodambakam meeting, 30 credit hours into 4 study hour, you must have 120 study hours. Then you will be able to say to. If you think you need something, you please talk to us first, let us see, and then proceed. This is for the retrospective. Prospective up to 2023. We have IMA Kodambakam has been given the go-ahead to conduct CME and grant credit points. Credit hours, sorry. Now, we are now conducting the meeting for 2 hours or 3 hours. This is earning us only half credit hour. It is now proposed and it is under consideration and tremendous discussion how we can make this into 1 credit hour. The jury is still out. We have ourselves not reached any decision on this, but we will keep you posted. So this is up to 2023. Those of you who have colleagues or sons or daughters who are doctors who are unlikely to go anywhere else for any other meeting, please bring them here in large numbers. We will be able to satisfy the requirement over the next 5 years without going anywhere else.
Fantastic.
Rather than me circulating, if you individually feel you don't have, you come. It is easier.
How do I know that? How do you have a certificate?
I have prepared.
That can be.
I will share the summary.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
just wanted to say is, if you, very simple, if you all make it very regular for our CME meet that happens on the last Sunday of every month, if you come for this without fail, 5 years, you are done. You don't have to worry about anything else.
You mean all the 1,000 members?
All members.
Where is the space?
We'll find it out.
There is a will, there is a way.
See, it is only a matter of how do we want to proceed further, right? We cannot be like this, so we have to do something on this. So if you attend our monthly meeting, that is enough. 5 years, not stop. That's enough.
This is also under discussion, how to do it. Because coming to IMA monthly meeting, you don't have to travel anywhere else. No station. No FT registration fee. No time away from clinic. This is Sunday afternoon evening. It's easily manageable. Even for those people who cannot travel out of the city, or for youngsters who cannot go, this is a safe, viable option. You enhance your knowledge, have good food, good company, fantastic advice from seniors, you get a built to ourselves.
Okay.
And if you also call a person from some other state for this meeting occasionally once in 2 or 3 months, the credit hour increases for us. It comes under national level.
Well, the last thing is not to worry about. If you don't attend anywhere, there is a website linked credit points with the Tamil Nadu Medical Council, which is already established. Two overseas
officers. Just one.
No, yeah, that's exactly. And you have the face recognition will be done very soon. You cannot open and you cannot make your sister, staff to sit there or your child to sit there. And then you get the answer to the question and then you get the credit point that is going to be off after 6 months. Face recognition will be there. If 2 hours you are going to sit in front of the computer, read the complete thing and answer, you will get from at home also the same credit hours. It's not necessary to come to even our CME or anywhere into the world. Sit in your clinic whenever you are free. No, that is there. You don't need to worry about at the end.
Parallels, every rule and regulation, there are contesting. People are contesting everywhere.
The last is, you see, maybe this year we will extend, but next 5 years it is going to be because it is Medical Council of India formulated. Most of the other medical council states have already done. Delhi members are paying 1,000 rupees, as I know. Punjab has told this time not, but next 5 years it is going to be RRA. So this year maybe we will get extension or anything, but not next time. So definitely we have to get credit hours of 30 hours for next 5 years. There is no doubt. Anytime, they have appointed some people for this.
Mostly non-medical persons. CEA. Are you asking about CEA?
Yeah, yeah.
What the team? Sir, the team is comprises of 8 members. The team leader is a doctor, not in private practice. He or she is in government service, doing administrative work only, not even working in the hospital. The team leader is a doctor. 7 members, 2 are from DMS office, 2 are from medical council, 2 are from office staff, like that they are divided. When they come and sit in the clinic, they take down the application form. They will call and say, sir, I am coming in 15 minutes. Be ready. Take a printout of your application form. Then they ask you to sign. They compare the signature which you have uploaded with the signature now you are making. They are asking you for your registration number. The minute you say the registration number, one fellow sitting in the back takes his mobile tablet and starts keying in and verifying that you are that registration number and this is your degree registered. Whether you are practicing the same specialty. Like that, they are working in tandem. Whole thing is over within 20 minutes. They say okay then and there, they give you the date on which the certificate will be delivered. Then either you go and collect it or they send it to you. It's as simple as that. But you must have mandatory proof filled up everywhere. They will come and see. And before they enter the clinical establishment,
They spend 10 minutes in the shop outside just to find out which doctor is coming here at what time. That also they are checking. I found out from the vendors around my consulting room. They came later and told me, sir, I need to check that. No more thanks for that. So this is what is happening. As long as you are plain and frank on everything, there is no issue at all. Going back to credit hours, is there any doubt from any member regarding credit hours? Sir, just like every rules and regulations in any walk of life, there are people who are conforming to it and there are people who are fighting against it. If you have seen the WhatsApp group messages, Karnataka High Court has said, Karnataka Medical Council has got no business in asking members to go and study and get CME points, etc. Ultimately, these may win or these may fail. We should not care about it. Are we conforming to the majority? Let us do it. Doctors generally have been poor planners. Another emphasis that UP PLS is 3 years, because we haven't saved much. Similarly, doctors are people who think about today, not about tomorrow. So, in any credit ever earned money, in any CEA register money, according to general population, we will keep moving ahead. So, let us go and get this thing done. Let us not dilly-dally or wait on it. Because as Dr. Arunachalam said, last week the website will crash. Maybe people will find that they have many number of establishments to see. Maybe the last date will get extended. Who knows? They say that there are 1 lakh clinical establishments in Chennai. Let us say you have a team of 100 members. It will take 1,000 days. It's just not possible. And there will be many people who don't have 30 tickets, who come back.